celebration of the third Sunday in ordinary time. Few announcements. Wednesday's devotions will be at Holy Spirit during the month of January. Please come together with our community to enjoy this special afternoon with song and prayer. The Red Cross will be conducting a blood drive on February the 4th at the Church of the Holy Spirit Gymnasium. Please check the bulletin to schedule an appointment. Next weekend, Father Matt will say the prayer of the blessing of the throats over those present rather than the individual blessing using cross candles. Introduction to the celebration. Like Jonah, Jesus calls the world to conversion. Let us come into God's presence with grateful hearts. Our celebrant today is Father Matthew Wenzel. Please stand. reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Set out for the great city of Nineveh, and announce it to the message that I will tell you." So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh, according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey through the city, and gone at a single day's walk, announcing, 40 more days more, and Nineveh shall be destroyed." But the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, he repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord. Letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the time is running out. From now on, let those having wives act as not having them, those weeping as not weeping, those rejoicing as not rejoicing, those buying as not owning, those using the world as not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they abandoned their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat, mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our Lord continues to call us. That is a good thing. It really truly is. It is good news. He continues to call us. He continues to seek us out. Now, last weekend, you may have recalled how we heard the calling of the first disciples from John's perspective, from the Gospel according to John. This week, we hear the calling of the first disciples from Mark's book point of view, and he has them situated in their boats, and nets, fishing, and Jesus calling them, and they go and they respond, and they and then they listen to the word of God through Jesus, and they go and follow him as he begins his ministry. I think it is good for us to listen to these calling stories over the course of 2 weeks, because it helps us to remember that God is continuing to call each and every one of us. He is continuing to call our country to come together, to listen to his word, to be moved by it, to be inspired by it, and to go and to make disciples of all nations as well, to go and to make our communities places where God's love is readily found, where the word of God is accepted. We also realize, too, that there will also always be a need for conversion. There will always be a need for repentance. And we hear about that in our scripture readings this weekend as well, too. Our first reading this weekend, taken from the book of Jonah, is a reminder of conversion. Now, the book of Jonah, to a certain extent, is a very interesting book. It really, really is. It's interesting because it is very short. It is only 4 chapters long. And biblical scholars debate as far as when exactly it was written, and in some cases they wonder, was it written to chronicle an actual person, or in some ways, does it really serve more of an extended parable? For instance, we have Jonah, the kind of the cranky prophet who, quite honestly, his heart is really not in this work at all, and yet God uses him anyway. He tries to flee away from his original assignment, only to be on this boat that is about to tip over because of the storm. He is then swallowed by a whale and spat out onto the seashore, where he goes, and he, you know, half-heartedly goes through Nineveh, the capital of Assyria. And when the king and all the servants hear this, and the people of the kingdom, they repent from their evil, and they, and God relents in punishment. And Jonah, instead of being happy for them, he sulks. He sulks, and he basically thinks that this is so unfair. It's a quirky little book, it really is, but it is also a reminder that, yes, God continues to call us to conversion, and God is also very generous in giving second chances. And our second reading for this weekend, taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, reminds us that having a healthy sense of urgency is a good thing. Now, in this case, when he says those who are celebrating, let them not act like they're celebrating, or for those who have wives, not act like they have wives, believe that the second coming will be happening soon. And clearly, even though it didn't, it is good to remember to not delay responding to the Word of God, but respond to it and to be joyful about it, and to want to share that good news with others. And so may we continue to look at these words and then consider what they mean for us, what they mean for our communities, what they mean for all people. To listen to how Jesus called all these ordinary fishermen to become his disciples. And likewise, he calls each and every one of us in our own way to be a reflection of that light. It doesn't mean that the light that we share comes from us and comes only from ourselves, but rather we see that we ourselves are loved by God first, and because we are loved by God, we can then go and share that love with others.
Lord, hear our prayer. world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter on earth, but only save the Virgin, my soul shall be healed.
I Which elephants live in the Arctic?
The coal ones.
That's kind of scary.